Hello everybody, welcome back to Dragonball's Universe, where Krux waits until I'm getting ready to make a comment about someone who died without realizing that they died. And then tries to pin it on me. But it's not my fault, because I didn't know he died because he freaking paused dramatically to see if I said anything to make it what made me look bad. Anyways, what were you gonna say, Krux?
Another woman calling, terrified, whispering into the phone, says she's locked in a closet with her kids, thinking a home invasion robbery. As soon as I get her address, I slam the call in and get ready to start updating quickly. Why was she huddled in her closet, terrified and on the verge of tears? Glad you asked. This woman saw a mouse in her house and was terrified. And didn't know what to do because her military husband was deployed. So she called 911 to get an officer to come out and take care of the mouse for her.
Uh-huh.
An officer did his duty, your tax dollars at work.
Oh my god.
Had a woman get so angry about her kids playing outside on their ATVs and bikes on their family's property in the middle of the day in the summer that she had a stroke. She's ranting and raving, and then all of a sudden she's speaking slowly and her words are slurred and she's groaning. It was a weird thing to happen, but she didn't need to be so damn angry about something like that.
I don't get it.
She called to complain about kids playing with their ATVs and bikes on their family's property, and she had a stroke in the middle of the call.
Well then.
Yep.
Did she die?
Not that I know of.
It's all Krux's fault. I blame Krux entirely.
Woman called to complain that her McDonald's triple thick milkshake isn't thick.
Did you get a Diet Coke with all that?
The milkshake is a drink. She got a salad with it.
Oh my god.
Let's see. Had an Amber Alert go out. Guy stabbed the mother of his children and took the kids. With this body. Man calls to complain that the alert is interrupting his TV and that the father should be left alone because he's doing a good thing to be with his kids.
Okay, that guy's clearly lost his freaking mind.
Apparently. Woman calling to ask where she can get a paternity test done for herself.
What, she impregnate herself?
I was confused and asked her to clarify if she was needing to determine who the father of the child was. She'd have to maybe contact a clinic. No, she wanted to find out if she was the mother of someone who claimed she gave birth to them. No mental illness, no hysterical pregnancy, she was just dumb. Entitled rich brat, oh this is gonna be good, demands an officer drive her back home because she spent her travel money partying.
Okay.
She felt that since her father was a well-known surgeon and a higher taxpayer, she should get a break and get a ride. I told her no and promptly hung up on her.
What'd she do, call back?
No.
Huh.
Guy calling to argue that his crystal meth is legal because he made it with store-bought products and this is all part of money.
Wait, what? Before you
die. The guy was making crystal meth because he was making it with store-bought products with money.
Okay. And why did he call the police about this?
Because he wanted to argue that it was legal because he went through proper channels.
Oh my god.
How dare you!
Idiots.
Let's see here. What is the next one?
Why is that doing no damage? That wasn't fair at all.
Oh, this is totally fair.
No, it's freaking spirit ball.
Let's see here. When I was 3 years old, we were at a pizza place and I had to pee. I was old enough that I could head to the bathroom myself or something, but there was a payphone outside the bathroom. I dialed the... 1 second. What?
Oh. These... Okay, never mind. They're right. Basically, three player NPCs appeared all of a sudden for this quest, and I was afraid that some of them might be little ladies or something. Thankfully, they're not. Go ahead.
Damn it.
I at least have the courtesy to not make that happen when it's required to fight them.
Yeah, that's true. Anyways, so... When this guy was 3 years old or so, they were at a pizza place, had to be old enough to go to the bathroom himself, and there was a payphone outside the bathroom. Dialed the only number they knew, 911, and said random things into the phone. I figured I couldn't make a call without paying, so it didn't actually do anything.
Oh my god.
The fire department showed up. Yep. When I was young, between 5 and 9, I taught my brother how to call 911 in the event of an emergency. Such a good older sibling. I dialed it, hung up, and they called back. Parents had to be sure that nothing was wrong. Apparently I taught my brother well, because we soon received another call to the house to ensure everything was okay. My parents again reassured dispatch that everything was okay, and the police car showed up at the house.
That's great.
Hey, but, well, you're teaching.
Oh, he just kept doing it over and over for no reason?
No. The guy called, the older sibling called because he was showing his younger sibling how to call in the event of an emergency, and then the younger sibling called a little bit later. Yeah.
Well, kid can't help it, but... That guy is an idiot.
Yeah.
Had good intentions. Still an idiot.
Oh my god, this is a good one. Okay, telephone triage nurse. So not 911, but a 24-hour hotline for people to call when they're having a medical problem, but aren't sure if they need to go to the ER or not.
Uh-huh. Do tell.
A quite pregnant. Don't remember exactly how far.
Why do they have to say it like that?
What?
I said, why do they have to say it like that?
Don't know, but definitely past 30 weeks. Woman calls to say that her doctor told her to refrain from having sex for the rest of the pregnancy and she didn't understand why. I looked at her file and saw that she was having preterm contractions, so I explained that sexual activity can cause contractions. So it was safer to abstain so the baby can stay inside as long as possible.
Uh-huh.
She tearfully exclaims, "How will I feed the baby?" There's more.
That's so horrible.
Can I go on? Can I go on?
Go ahead, but Jesus Christ.
Okay. Okay, telephone nurse. "I'm sorry, ma'am, could you repeat that? How will I feed the baby if I can't have sex?"
Why?
The patient was convinced that her baby was living off her boyfriend's semen, and that it would starve if they stopped having sex.
You know, the sad thing is, chances are the boyfriend told her that just so he'd keep having sex.
I'm pretty sure that happened. I explained about the umbilical cord, etc., but she refused to believe me until I asked her about single moms, lesbian moms, etc. And asked how she, through their babies, fed and grew. After a moment of silence, she thanked me and started to hang up the phone, but not before I heard her screaming her boyfriend's name.
Oh my god.
That actually happened.
So wait, so what, he did tell her that?
What? Yes, he did tell her that. He set her bark of missiles so they could have. That man had a good thing going for a while there. I honestly wasn't sure if I felt more sorry for him or a baby growing up in that household.
My lord.
That was funny.
That was funny. But it hurt. Stupidity hurt. Good lord.
I understand her reason for believing the boyfriend. But still. Why?
It's a freaking guy. Of course it's gonna do something like that. But Jesus Christ.
Let's see. Oh, another one. Was a triad. Call 911 at least twice for people who refuse to. Why would you call primary physician's office to say my throat is closing up? I said I'm hanging up and calling 911 for you right now. And I heard a whisper scream.
What?
She was transported with an allergic reaction and was extremely angry with me due to her bills and tried to have me fired because they called 911 for her.
She would have freaking died otherwise.
I guess she thought that calling the triage nurse was better than getting fined for transport after calling 911. Second time was a woman describing stroke-like symptoms and wanted to see our nurse practitioner who didn't have an opening for 3 weeks.
Oh my god.
I told her that the symptoms sounded like a stroke and that she needed to call 911, but she kept insisting I schedule her with the NP. Finally, I hung up and called for her and she was in fact having a stroke.
Did she get mad?
I don't know.
She probably did.
Let's see here.
Oh, Lord.
Okay, here we go. This was me doing the dumb call. I was a passenger and my boyfriend was driving. I had my phone locked and in my pocket and accidentally butt dialed 000, the Australian equivalent of 911.
Mm-hmm.
The radio was on, so I didn't hear anything, but the dispatcher obviously heard muffled voices and random noises.
Oh my god.
Yep. I started to receive calls back from a different number I did not know. I tend not to answer unknown numbers, but after two or three calls back, I picked up. Cue awkward conversation where the dispatcher clearly thought I was in a domestic situation and couldn't talk and was trying to talk in code, but with the possibility of the phone being on speaker or whatever, especially when I denied calling 000 in the first place.
Oh, for God's sake.
Bless that person who was trying to do the right thing in what they thought was a serious situation, but was honestly just my butt.
Oh, at least they tried to do something good.
Yep.
You know, the sad thing is I remember there's actually been a call. This one was like a bad one on the police's part. I guess the dispatcher's fault. But, I don't remember specifically what the situation was. But, like, someone called the police because something really bad was happening. Like, I think someone was dying or something like that. And the person was obviously really freaked out and, cursing and all that. And the police mm-hmm. officers, after a while, the police officer said, how about you call back when you calm down and stop cursing at me, and then hung up on them when something serious was
lovely.
Happening.
Yeah. Oh, here we go. Oh my god. Okay. I know I say oh my god a lot on here. I'm sorry, guys. I'm just like... the stupidity.
Yeah.
And unexpected hilarity of this call. Okay, someone working for EMS Communications here. They get their share of object stuck calls every now and then. It will be a kid with a gummy bear in his or her ear. Most often, it is items stuck up adults' butts by their own hands.
Okay. Every little Saiyan
remaining. List of three things include mice, kinky sex toys, and wine bottles. Please note, if the bottle of wine is empty, it will create a vacuum.
Oh my god.
You name it.
Wait, what? Of course.
What?
If a bottle of wine is empty, it'll create a vacuum.
Because you're sticking it up your butt and it still has air inside of it. Now, of course, this only occurs in some faraway place. Wrong. It's happening every night, right down the street, in your cozy neighborhood. It's the most normal-looking people you know.
Mm-hmm.
Funniest involved only a kinky sex toy. Accidentally. It was accidentally, stacked too deep in this guy's butt by some chick. It was deep. What made it such a great call was that his ex-girlfriend had invited him over to forgive him for some past betrayal, and things got steamy. He was the one who called it in, and trust me, he was none the wiser that this was no accident.
Oh my god.
I only wish I could have seen her face as she searched massive on Amazon.
What? I'm so confused.
Apparently, she searched massive sex toy, or whatever it was, bought that, invited her boyfriend over, and things got steamy.
Oh my god.
Yep.
Okay, so
I got stuck.
This is a repeat of a mission that I actually really hate from Xenoverse 1, although I think, thankfully, it's not for the skill that it was for Xenoverse 1, so I don't have to grind as much. Originally, this is the mission you had to grind for Super Saiyan. And it took forever.
Okay.
Because to get the conditions to happen, you have to have Krillin killed. You have to let Frieza kill Krillin. And
that is annoying.
Frieza is very cooperative when it comes to killing Krillin.
Hmm. Let's see here.
It's completely reliant on dumb AI.
Okay. I think this is the last one.
Uh-huh.
Not a 911 operator, but a paramedic. People abuse 911. Make no mistake about it. I'll talk about one of my dumber calls recently.
Okay.
Anyone who works in EMS have a sea of dumb calls. They can tell you about drowning in. I got toned out for a homeless guy we had just taken in earlier that shift. When we pulled up, he was standing there with his bags packed up, smoking a cigarette. He said he had chest pain this time. 12 lead in a focus exam revealed nothing except subjective information that kept changing. You get to a point where you can spot your fakers. I brought him back to the ER. Turns out he just left his hat from earlier and wanted a free ride back to the hospital to get it. So he faked a heart attack, called us, and signed out AMA after he snagged his hat.
Oh my god.
He was listening when he walked out through the lobby. Meanwhile, during the run, a call goes up for a kid having an allergic reaction. I missed that call. Would have been the unit to respond had old boy here not needed a ride to get his hat.
Oh my god. Like, the kid didn't die, did he?
As far as I know, someone else got him.
Okay, good.
So as far as calls go, there's one online somewhere around about a woman who called 911 after McDonald's messed up her order. It didn't surprise me. Here are a few highlights over the last bit. Had a run about someone claiming their oxygen levels were too high. COPD patient on home oxygen.
Mm-hmm.
2-liter nasal cannula. Pulse read 100%. I'm not even gonna try to understand that. No breathing difficulty. Instructed her to remove her oxygen and it resolved pretty quickly. But we still brought her in as per her request. another run where an elderly gentleman's glucose was 85 and he just knew he was dying. The normal amount is 80 to 120.
Wait,
someone calling about toe pain. What?
Wait, so what happened?
Elderly gentleman's glucose levels were 85 and he was convinced he was dying when the normal amount for his age is 80 to 120.
Oh my god.
Let's see here. Someone called about toe pain at 3 a.m. on a Saturday night.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, someone called 911 because they were having chest pains. Absolutely thought they were gonna die. Never called 911 before, so they had no idea what to expect. As it turns out, they found out two things. One, they were sick with the flu, including body aches in the chest, muscles, and arms, which are sure signs of a heart attack. And two, she had a severe panic attack.
Of course.
Which was causing shortness of breath and an increased heart rate.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Well then.
Mm-hmm.
Sounds like a dingleberry to me.
Oh, yes. Oh, speaking of dingleberries.
Seriously?
Yes.
Wait. Go ahead. Just.
I'm kidding. Let's see here. Ex-911 operator worked in the Midwest. Lots of your garden variety daily dumb calls, but this is next level stupid. Okay, so 911, what is the location of your emergency? Address? So I'm not really sure if this is an emergency. This is so embarrassing. They answered an ad on Craigslist for some services with a woman. Somehow this ends in you dialing 911 at 1 a.m.
Oh my god.
Answer the ad that said, send me what you got. So I sent her, you know, some pictures. I got a reply that said I had sent these photos to his daughter who was 16.
Wait, what?
Apparently the daughter of this gentleman had a Craigslist ad for services? And it was asking for pictures, so this guy who called 911 sent her pictures.
Okay.
They didn't know, thought someone put her number there as a joke. So, want to speak with an officer, what's the name? I don't want to say my name and get in trouble or anything. I'm just worried that this needs to be brought to someone's attention and get it out there, you know? Meanwhile, this is all on a recorded line with all the information on their computer.
Yeah.
Chrissy. They transfer the call to the duty sergeant, hoping he'll open up to another dude. He does. Then when the truth erupts into a twisted tale of a love trapezoid, straight out of M. Night Shyamalan's diary,
okay.
It turns out the caller wasn't a child predator at all, he was just a tiny kid on the prowl for a very legal kitty.
Wait, what?
He was basically on the prowl for some legal-aged women and ended up falling for a very young catfisher.
Oh joy.
A particular ad from a woman in a city called Hooker, claiming to be 25 years old, piqued, among other things, his interest, and he dutifully complied to the demand for, well, dick pics. After a brief time later, he was textually accosted by a reasonably enraged man claiming to be the father of the alleged juvenile. He apologized. Yeah, so the 16-year-old made up a profile claiming to be 25 years old.
Oh, for God's sake.
The guy apologizes profusely and attempts to explain the situation by sending the father a link to the ad in question, presumably followed by the ordering of the P90X, whatever that is, and a gathering of bail money. It is at this point that the story takes a nosedive. The father isn't a father. The father's identity becomes husband.
Wait, what? But isn't she underage?
His innocent little girl's phone is actually the phone of his wife.
Oh my god.
This is M. Night Shyamalan stuff. They should make this a movie. Apparently the dispatcher believes that most 16-year-olds haven't been sexually dissatisfied long enough to turn to a Craigslist ask for women for men. That's women for multiple men, by the way.
Okay.
To clarify, the kid thinks he sent dick pics to a child after seeing an ad on Craigslist asking for multiple men, calls 911 when he receives text from a man claiming to be the father of his child, threatening violence and jail time. Investigation ensues. Dick pic recipient is actually the cheating wife from a city called Hooker.
Hey!
Well then. Okay.
Oh my god. Did you get all that?
I get it, sort of. And that's a good note to end the episode on. So if you enjoyed this, leave a like and subscribe, leave a comment, possibly leave a donation, and we'll see you in the next episode.
Good night, everybody. Sweet dreams. Don't think of this nightmare.
Have a good night, everybody. Oh, Lord.